The Faith I Live By, a devotional by Ellen G. White.
A hatred of sin. Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore God, even thy God, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 9. When in conversion the sinner finds peace with God through the blood of the atonement, the Christian life has but just begun. The grace that Christ implants in the soul creates in man enmity against Satan. Without this converting grace and renewing power, man would continue the captive of Satan, a servant ever ready to do his bidding. But the new principle in the soul creates conflict where hitherto had been peace. The power which Christ imparts enables man to resist the tyrant and usurper. Whoever is seen to abhor sin instead of loving it, whoever resists and conquers those passions that have held sway within, displays the operation of a principle wholly from above. Conformity to the world and harmony with Christ cannot be maintained. Worldly maxims and worldly practices sap spirituality from heart and life. Conformity to the world means resemblance to the world in meeting the world's standard. No man can serve the world and Jesus Christ at the same time. There is an irreconcilable antagonism between Christ and the world. How few can say, "I am dead to the world, the life I now live is by faith in the Son of God." While those around us may be vain and engaged in pleasure-seeking and folly, our conversation is in heaven, whence we look for the Savior. The soul is reaching out after God for pardon and peace, for righteousness and true holiness. Converse with God and contemplation of things above transform the soul into the likeness of Christ. Let your heart be softened and melted under the divine influence of the Spirit of God. You should not talk so much about yourself, for this will strengthen no one. Talk of Jesus and let self go. Let it be submerged in Christ.